Hello and welcome, I'm Fala, and today we are going to be wiping the floor with aliens. Hello, hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of XCOM Long War Impossible Season 3. Today we are taking on a Gangplank mission. This is going to be a very important mission since the new month just started, and we need the money because we're running below the ground really. So I need to take this thing and sell its contents. Basically, we are taking it straight to the scrapyard. But excellent. Let's not share the skin on a bear that's still alive. I'm taking on the best people I can for the situation without putting anyone in exhaustions, because I don't want to exhaust anyone. We have a very weak roster and I can't afford to do that. So yeah, we are going, and this is gonna hurt. This isn't going to be an easy mission. We are looking at potential casualties once more, just as we have somewhat recovered from losing Alloy Jesus.
We're heading into China for the next operation.
But it is time to pirate that ship and take it to the dock so that our specialists can take it apart, and we will take anything that we can use and sell most of it, really. And here is the cutscene. We are boarding the ship, singing yar har fididi. Being a pirate is all I can be. There we are.
Big Sky took care of the delivery, but now comes the hard part. If we're going to set that battleship down intact, we'll have to start by disabling the power conduits positioned across its surface. There's no telling what we're going to find up there, but we should expect heavy resistance from the alien forces manning that ship. We have a new objective.
Okay, so we have to do this mission realistically. That means first we are going to prepare... I'm going to, as usually, take on through the mission phase by phase. In the first phase we must secure the position in here and rain dead on everything that's below, while also keeping a lookout on the aliens, which are probably aware of us by now. So I'm going to be moving slower than I can.
Solid copy.
Just in case something decides to, I don't know, jump down behind me. I'm going to dash a couple of people because there is no reason not to, really. But mostly we will overwatch.
Hostiles are closing on your position, Strike One. Eyes open, people.
So again, we expect the heaviest resistance while we start our encroach on the ship. That's when the aliens will want to hit us strongest. And then they will probably toss their tertiary and so on troops to fend us off. Okay, they drop in over there, which means that the scout is moving in first. We need the lightning reflexes to tell us where the alien is. Okay, we will be able to get there without activating it. That's good news.
That's affirmative.
We must take secure positions right now. This is just not something that is up for discussion. Okay. We are expecting at least this one tin mint to come up to fight us. So everybody who can will be in some sort of cover. I won't be using a smoke yet. Mostly because we have to get David Rice over there. And yeah, unfortunately this is as good as it gets, and we will have to have them overwatches be effective against the incoming team. And I'm not going to steady Garrett's weapon right now because he's not gonna be shooting any rockets next turn no matter what. Oh, we can already hear the cyber disc, that's interesting. Well, the cyber dick is not something I want to meet down there, but we are going to toss a battle scanner as the first thing we do, because we will not be using a shotgun right off the bat. We want to see what's down there before I commit.
The conduits positioned on the surface of that battleship are tied directly into the ship's power grid. If we can disable the conduits or destroy them with explosives, it should put that thing out of commission, allowing us to seize its cargo without the risk of collateral damage.
Thank you, Bradford. Unfortunately, it doesn't really tell us much. We haven't detected any enemies, so we gotta take it by the balls. Okay, so far so good.
On the move.
So far so good.
Moving.
So far so good. It's gonna go bad eventually.
Got it.
Got something.
There we are. So yeah, this is the turn we are going to use smoke. I think I may be able to get a rocket over there. Nope. So yeah, everyone's going to overwatch except for Mr. Rice, who's going to keep himself smoked so that the big bad aliens won't be able to get to him. They will still be able to shoot, I can't retreat.
Moving to overwatch.
And that will be all she wrote. We have to move forward.
I'm on it.
Up, stop, stop. No, no, no. Don't steady weapon. You have a shot. Take it. Bloody hell. That's one potential psi panic less to worry about. So, what should King Rike do? We can go to the right where we will be safe, or take this little tile over here. That's a nice tile, isn't it? Except that it can potentially be in a floater's field of view.
On my way.
Well, fuck, who doesn't risk doesn't eat.
Roger that. It's about to heat up over there, Strike One. X-rays are making their way to your position.
So yeah, unfortunately we did not manage to take positions without activating the enemies, but we are in smoke. And we have a couple of advantages over the enemy. First of all, the height advantage, then we have the overwatches on them. Why do I always put snipers on overwatch? They never hit anything. Well, I hope that floater isn't gonna be close enough for a flank or a good shot at me. I got scared there for a moment. Okay, so this guy's going to be King Rike's first target. And there is also a Tin Mint, okay. So maybe not, maybe Tin Man. Whoop. The fuck. What the fuck is wrong with those Tin Mints? Okay, luckily we managed to get rid of one. And that means shotgun is gonna have to go back and take care of that fucker. Okay, so what can we do? We have not been in any possibility to fight against those fucks. So the only thing I can theoretically do is maybe I can shoot a rocket, find the Muton. But he's gonna be in cover anyway, no matter what I do. King Rike should open fire, but he has to get rid of the Tin Mint infestation. That guy's gonna be hit by overwatches when he approaches. And Kyo isn't going to be fast enough to get him anyway. I'm gonna hit overwatch with Kyo. We're in smoke and with lightning reflexes, I don't believe that there is any risk whatsoever. Yes, we are. Okay, so let's holo target the guy that's further ahead. Because I want Sniper King Rike to take care of him.
Heading to that location.
Oh, and he cannot, okay. And that's one thing down.
Roger,
now David is going to take care of this guy, hopefully. Ay, papi.
Target still up. Heading out. Moving to overwatch.
Yeah, I have to take care of the little thing, little fishy called Wanda over there. Who is overwatching me right now, but he's gonna have to dash to do anything, so I don't care.
I'm on it.
Yeah, I really don't care. That Tin Man is gonna have to dash to be able to shoot me, I think. It's too far away for a shot at anybody. I hope, bloody hell, I'd hate to be wrong. Let's just say I'd hate to be wrong, because then he'd have a clear dash on everyone, because of general reasons of suckiness. That Muton is gonna eat at least two of the Overwatches, if not more. All depending on Van Dork. There we are.
Enemies down.
I'm scared that maybe the floater is going to come for a flank now, but he shouldn't because there is an Overwatch and floaters are scared of Overwatches. There is Teen Mint incoming also from the column. And one behind me. He should eat Gunner's Overwatch and not be able to do anything, but you never know, you know? Okay, I literally cannot take the lack of knowledge about what's happening. But what can I do? I'm gonna send Tiny. Tiny can see it. Okay. Where did it go?
Reloaded.
Move it to Overwatch.
Got it covered.
Well, there is only one thing we can do. We can set up Overwatches until it is safe. We will keep a guard on a steadied weapon. Just in case.
Overwatch.
And yeah, I hope I have enough Overwatches to get rid of the Tin Man and the floater at the same time. They are both coming my way now. We have to hold the position in here. That's just there is just no other option. Oh yeah, good job, people. Good job.
X-ray neutralized.
So far, so good. Again, we don't know where is the Tin Meat.
Come get some.
I'm on it. Roger, got my eyes on.
Scanning.
Got it covered.
So we will have to wait. It is going to come to me eventually. And even though I am looking the other way than it is theoretically coming, I can't let it stay there. I can't move on until it is gone. Okay, things are looking a little better now, so I'm gonna send Kyo.
Scanning.
To locate those fuckaroonies. Where did it go? I must know. Maybe it jumped off somewhere. I don't know.
Affirmative. Covering now.
And it's killing me. I must.
Roger that. Scanning.
Got it covered.
Well, if it comes through that little door, there is totally enough Overwatches to deal with it. And
you hear anything?
Even if it doesn't, Kyo is going to go and finish it off in a moment. We still hear rowing bands of mutants coming up, and there is a Tin Mint. It's gonna shoot. Whoa!
Take it fire over here.
That's a fucker. And now they're incoming. Come on, King Rike. Don't let it get away. It looks like a hit. Please tell me it's gonna kill. Oh yes! It's a wound, not a kill, but still better than nothing. It can shoot from there. Fuck!
Incoming fire!
Okay, so I was extremely lucky right now. Very extremely lucky. Lucky, I can't even say.
Nailed him.
Okay, now our path is clear once more, and I'm having a mini heart attack right now. Holy crap.
I'm ready.
I'm going to use a moment to reload. Change my diapers and then we can start moving out.
Good to go.
Moving out.
Okay, looks like we have managed to get shit done for now. Okay, that means we have managed to establish our presence on the ship without being kicked off by the aliens immediately. But it doesn't mean our ride is over. Oh no, it doesn't. It means we have a lot to do. So the second part of phase one is going to be, we are going to be moving half of the fire team through this corridor. Use that jump thing to get on the tower that is here. I can already see it like this. And the other half is going to go that way so that nothing surprises us. We are going to theory, sneakily get to the top of the tower. I need to have all my people on the towers to the end of phase one, and they will be overwatching always, so that nothing surprises me.
Headed there now.
And yeah, that would be it. That would be phase one.
Here they come.
Oh shit. That's a bit scary. So I'm going to want to once more take care of the sectoid with the sniper, I think. I believe Kyo can take care of the floater, but actually no. You know what's the most dangerous enemy? The mutonies. So 1%er goes there. Why a 1%er? That's very simple. We are going to be breaking that mutant's cover. We will probably kill the sectoid while at it, so sniper won't have to do it. Not really. But we at least broke the mutant's cover, and that means it's going to be vulnerable. It's the most dangerous enemy. It has the biggest gun. Van Dork can easily take care of the floater, I believe. Because that's Van Dork. That's right, Van Dorn, mid floater, floater, mid Van Dorn. I didn't expect you to, Van Dorn. I didn't expect you to. Okay, now we need just one more shot to get rid of the Muton. So I'm going to use Maverick to do that. 90%. That's right, dead and gone. Maverick never fails. And Tiny is going to take a easy shot against the sectoid. Boya! Bounchiki wow wow, you've been fucked. Unfortunately, it costed me one of my rockets, but... Oh, there is another floater, fuck no! It's flanked, so it's not gonna stay there, probably. Oopie-day, I did not see that coming, okay. What do we do? I hope Kingrike has ammunition still, because if he does, we can just snipe that shit down. If not, Tiny has a shot. Oh crap, we have no ammunition in Kingrike's rifle, so reload it is. And
moving out.
Kyo is going to go down. I hope he's gonna get a view on that floater, because we need holo. I'm not gonna disarm the bomb yet, because why? Why? Okay, so holo targeting is in place, and that means we are going to at least have a decent chance to kill the floater. Because our survival and success during this mission depends very highly on the ability to eliminate enemies. Okay, Maverick can theoretically flash it dead. But can he? He should be able to do it from cover, I don't want to risk him. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to just make sure that somebody else has a shot.
On my way.
Come on, Van Dorn.
Aye, aye.
Come on, David Rice. Nope. Okay, so theoretically I can get out of cover and flash that floater. It's going to be a very easy shot. But what if it misses? So that's why I'm going to go for the cover. And yeah, I have that shot anyway, just as I hoped.
Flashing him out.
Fuck yeah, Maverick Allen is the man.
Roger that.
You guessed it, boys and girls. You've got hostiles inbound. Stay frosty.
I'm always frosty. I'm cool as ice. Except when I'm not. Okay, so let's see the hostiles inbound. Boom! It's a chrysalid! So, well, Tiny can shoot it.
Negative.
And then Rike can finish it off. That's what you get when you bring claws and fangs to a gunfight, fucker. So yeah, now we can calmly advance. I don't think there is any danger of encountering any sort of enemies right now. And even if it is, I can't really get into cover right now. So I hope nothing teleports behind me right now. Please and thank you. Blocks.
I'm on the move.
And I guess just in case, I'm gonna have Garrett with on a steadied weapon.
I'm on the move.
Commander, whatever you just did seems to have stirred up the hornet's nest. The aliens are going to throw everything they've got at us to protect that ship.
And like they haven't before.
Scanning.
I have overwatches just in case. During this mission, the reload management and the ammunition management is crucial because I don't believe in taking additional ammunition. I believe that if you can't kill an alien with one bullet, you don't deserve to bring two. And that has a huge chance of coming back to haunt me, so I will have to reload my people in waves.
Locked and loaded.
I have three towers. And what else do you want me to say? And I'm going to be now gathering up my forces to deal with the situation in all of them.
Yes, Commander.
One by one.
Will do. Ready to engage.
I will, however, always make sure that I have people reloading and I have people overwatching.
Eyes peeled, Commander.
So that no BS can happen.
That's affirmative.
If anything drops down, I hope it's going to get greeted warmly. It's going to take me a moment to even reconvene everybody to get to the towers, so might as well take my time, right? So yeah, I'm going to cut out and put a board instead of the advance. It's going to take me like few minutes only, but I will not record in that time, and I will see you again once I have everyone on they're ready to get on the towers. See you in a jiffy. Okay, so I'm back. I have everybody set up to go on top of the tower. As you can see, we are all ready and willing to start operation phase 2. What are we doing? We are setting up on top of the tower. We are going to be overwatching for enemy contact. I'm going to leave some rear guard because the enemies may also spawn behind me.
Headed there now.
So we gotta be ready for them. That's just about it. And Douglas, I mean, is going to go for the front, while Van Dort is gonna go to the back. That's gonna be good. And here we will have David Rice over keeping my rear secure, while
gotcha.
Maverick is going to keep my front secure, and everything is ready. That was the wrong button.
On Overwatch. Affirmative. Covering now.
Ready to I'm gonna reload Kingreich because he might need the ammunition soon.
Hostiles are inbound to your location.
And we are going to kill them all once they arrive. We will kill them and then we will feast on their corpses. Alright, so there is one guy. He should be in my range or not really. But that's unfortunate. I hope somebody can see it. Not so much. I was afraid that might happen. There is only one thing I can't do since everyone is in the back, so gotta go there, right? Good redance. I wish it would be so easy for the Tin Mint as well, but that's not gonna happen.
Copy that.
Well, we can overwatch and make sure that it is going to be good.
On Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
Position confirmed.
Because it has to come now, so when it does, I'll be waiting. There is so many overwatches, one of them has to hit. Right? And I also hear there are mutants patrolling, I can hear their footsteps, so that's interesting. We might get into a really interesting firefight right now. So let's make sure that the Tin Mint is dead by then. That's very good. That's exactly what I wanted to see. And that means also we can now refocus on the forward flank.
Will do.
Kyoken is going to go and disable the bomb very soon.
Okay.
But first, let me take a selfie. I'm going to keep overwatches over here for one more turn.
I'm on the move.
Just because I think this might be a prudent thing to do.
Moving to Overwatch.
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 I heard the patrols and I just want them to see. I just want to see if they are going to come or not. We have very good positions and I'm sorry, but we are doing this realistically and that means I'm not leaving those positions. There is just no way. Except maybe to get here.
On the move.
Eyes peeled, Commander.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Ready to rock. Roger that, scanning.
On Overwatch.
Heads up, Strike One. We're picking up some strange readings near your op zone. Keep an eye out for hostile forces.
I am keeping my eye out for hostile forces, always. Even when I'm in the bathroom. I'm keeping an eye out open for marshmallows that want to break my scopes. Well, and once more. Once again, the enemy has spawned behind my back. I don't think it's going to be very dangerous. I just gotta take it down.
Target still up.
Affirmative.
Somebody has to hit it, and one or two hits are all I need. Actually, I think Garrett can take care of it. It was close, but no potatoes, so I'm gonna have Van Dork do it. And the Chrysalid is dead. The witch is dead.
Rock and roll.
Commander, that conduit is down, but it might be faster if our troops just hit the others with explosives.
Yeah, I don't really think you are the one to talk, Bradford. I mean, I'm sorry, but if you have been any good with strategy or tactics, you would not be a comm officer. I'm sorry. You're doing that job because you're a gratified secretary. There is a little box in my cell phone that can do your job, Bradford, so shut the fuck up about strategy. Thank you very much.
On my way. Overwatch.
Roger. Got my eyes on.
Asshole, isn't he? Just, hey, now I know more about tactics and strategy than you.
Eyes peeled, Commander.
Headed there now. Moving to
We're going to the other side of the room. And Kyoken is going to go and find me the enemy. I hear cyber disk and that's not a very good thing. Well, I know one should spawn when I reach the gates, but I already hear one, which means there is one on the map. And of course I'm acting like I don't know what that is, because that's the Spec Ops campaign prerogative that we don't use gaminess.
Ready to engage.
We are instead using reloads. I mean, reloading the weapons. I would very much want an enemy patrol to stumble into me. It would be very nice. But they, of course, don't wanna. I'm going to just check out. Okay. I had to lean over to see if the baby is still asleep, because, as you know, I have very limited time to the mission. It is until baby wakes up. So yeah, we are pretty much ready for the enemies to walk to me. Kyoken has a very difficult job, I must say. I think his job sucks, because his job is to work as a bait. We are going to be using a bait and switch tactics. We are going to bait the enemies to come to me.
Got it.
Hopefully, Kyoken is going to survive this.
We can't get a read on that thing.
On
its
what thing?
Are so inconsistent.
What the crap, dude? That's the last place I expected to see you. Okay, so can we reach it with a shredder rocket? Yes, we can. So let's. We gotta kill that disc. It just spawned right behind me. Thanks for the warning, Shen. So now that's a very good 5-point shredder rocket, that is awesome. And the rest is going to be history. There are shots that are going to follow. And that thing is as good as dead. We have two heavy rifles angled on it. We are going to be using a sniper rifle on top of that, and that's gonna be enough. Nice damage there, King Reich. Plop.
Nice field, Commander.
Got it covered.
So, this is what I want to do. Since I can keep hearing those patrols in the corridor ahead of me, I'm going to use Kyoken as a bait. We are going to get those fucks and we are going to retreat. There we are. We see two floaters, two mutons. They should be too far away to be dangerous for me. But we are retreating anyway, and what we have to do now, this is a very important thing, we have to have enough overwatches to make sure that we can keep Kyo safe, because we can't get smoke on for that distance. Kyo is going to make a double move when next turn, and then David Rice can use a smoke grenade, but for now Kyo is in danger, so everyone is overwatching, and I hope we can eliminate the enemies in time. Seems like we can. Okay, so get the hell out, Kyo.
On overwatch.
Eyes peeled, Commander.
Do I actually need a smoke grenade? Probably yes.
Smoke's in the air.
They stayed back for one turn, but I remember how I lost Alloy Jesus, and I don't want that to happen again. Simple as that. They can walk into me at their leisure, but that is it. Come on! We won't go down without a fight. There's a muton. It's a blood call, and we have a floater, and they are all in range. Oh! What the hell? Smoke didn't help. That's very not cool, bloody hell. Very not fucking cool. I'd say that this isn't right. Okay, so frankly, now that Scout is hungering down, we can't see those enemies because of panic, so we have to create a field of vision for ourselves. And we are going to be using a big ol' rocket.
Won't even know what hit him.
Which isn't going to do shit. That's not how I imagined it to happen. But at least we have a 72. So at the very least we have some cover. Smoke is still going to be working. It's now dispersing, but it is still there. We just have to get the hell out so that Rice can fix me. Don't be a bitch. Oh yeah! We have lots of overwatches, they may or may not be able to take care of the floaters. If they do, then I'm a happy hippie, because I don't have to shoot them in my turn. No such luck, however. They are a very difficult moving and flying target. And they're very annoying, as you can see. And then they want to... Whoa!
Taking fire over here.
They want to make my advantage into nothing, and I won't have that. So what we have? We have a shredder rocket. I'm going to need it because there is a second cyber dig. Well, come on, David. Oh yes, that's how I like it. That's also pretty good. And
I'm out of firepower over here.
here.
Looks like we rocked their socks off.
He's down. Out of rounds.
Checking now.
Roger, looking out.
Okay, now, what do I do? What do I do? I need to get Kyoken out of there. There is only one way. I can't go to any place that I would like. Unless it is the other side of the tower. Or I could attack, but that's not gonna work. I'm going to hunker down because I have no other choice.
They're trying to pull back.
Yeah, you go, bitch. He's trying to come the other way, which is all. What the hell? Cyberdisk is making noises. I think he's trying to go the other way, which is all the better for me because that gives me time to fix Kyo. Thanks God for alloy plating. He's not even wounded, remember.
Checking now.
Back in.
Good to go.
It also gives me some time to reload.
This? Oh, it's gonna hurt.
It's gonna hurt, but Kyoken is not wounded. It's just the alloy plating that's going to be damaged again. You people have to stop breaking my stuff. Oh, fuck. Van Dorn hit a drone. But I hope that they are all going to Overwatch right now, because if the Cyberdisk attacks, then we are going to be in a little bit of a pickle! Fuck you! I hate drones. Okay, but luckily for us, we have a Shredder rocket remaining, and it is a very good thing that I haven't used it, isn't it? Okay, Shredder rocket away. I think I moved my mouse, but the Cyberdisk is gonna get affected anyway.
This is gonna hurt.
Okay, what do we do now? We can't see this. Tiny's gonna wait. We can't see the Cyberdisk. Which isn't good. We have eliminated the drone, which is, I guess, okay-ish, but we can't see the Cyberdisk. Let's make it at least as safe as possible for me. Come on, Van Dorn, make it count. Okay, it's going to at least have problems aiming at me. Because the Red Fox starts to work on mechanical targets below 50% hit points. And that's where we just have gotten it. Kyoken has to get the hell out, there is no reason for everyone risking.
Scanning.
And the drone's gonna fix the Cyberdisk, Cyberdisk's gonna miss me. It's still just below 50%. Oh no, it's not, there is another drone. Oh no, 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 no! No! Van Dorn is okay because he's badass. Looks like there is fuckloads of enemies in there. Well, let's reduce them a little bit. Okay, so does Van Dorn still have any ammunition left? He does not, so Van Dorn's gonna get the hell out so that we can
locked and loaded.
Open fire safely.
Overwatch. Aye, aye.
I'm ready.
I'm on it, Commander. Keeping a lookout.
Okay, I'm going to have to hunker down so that the Cyberdisk comes to me. That's I guess that's in top 10 of the stupid things I do. I have Overwatches, and that's the best we can hope for. It's gonna fly closed, I think. And it's hardened, but I guess we gotta hope that our Overwatches are going to deal some damage to it. So far, so good. I'm mostly hoping for Maverick's auto laser because of hit ammo. It's a miss!
Missed.
We are in trouble. That cyber dick is dead. Luckily it got stuck on Van Dorn. It was a good decision to get him out of there. So now the drone is repairing it or it's repairing itself. It's either way all the same to me. What are we going to do? I'm going to go for a shotgun. Shotgun's too far away to hurt it, but it really is not meant to hurt it. It's meant to holo target. I would be so pissed if it would hit, really. And now we have a 70% hit ammo auto laser shot. That didn't crit, but it's still good. We are going to open it up and we are going to kill it. I King Reich, that wasn't good. Come on, David. David never misses, doesn't he? He just shoots, he doesn't care. I've never seen that guy miss once. Okay, we are little by little we are taking it apart. And Van Dorn did it.
Nice.
Stop breaking my battleship. It's mine. My precious battleship. Okay, so we actually made it out. And everyone's alive.
Got no ammo.
Now where is the last remaining muton? Because it's still out there, you know. That muton is still out there.
Back online.
But I'm going to check if I'm actually recording this, because I would be so pissed if I'm not. Yes, I am. Okay, that's fine. We need to reload before moving forward.
Overwatch. Aye, aye. Roger that. Scanning.
I guess I can get
Kyo
forward and hunker down. We don't want to see anything right now.
Heading out.
And Van Dorn can overwatch.
Shield, Commander.
And I want that mutant to come.
What was that?
So yeah, I don't think I will be moving and doing anything before that mutant returns, and that means I'm going to be overwatching a lot, so I will just not record it and put a see you later board in this place, and I will see you when it comes to fruition, and the ambush will close upon that mutant like a steel jaws of death, or when something else walks into me. So, see you in a moment. There it is! Okay, so it returned just in time. Took a moment and our overwatch is missed, oh fuck. Okay, good job, King Reich. So yeah, that mutant just surprised me. I was just started to stare out the window, really. And now we can't see it. That's not cool. What the fuck is it? Luckily we have Kyo, and Kyo is a scout.
Heading
so, he's gonna be scouting. What the hell?
I'm on it. Roger that.
I'm on it.
So the mutant apparently disappeared, and the only thing I can do about that is to overwatch. And hope we get it now. So it hid in that one tile we can't see. Alrighty then. We gotta do what we gotta do. And that's probably going to pick up another pod. Okay, there they are. And once again, Kyo is going to retreat next turn, and we are going to be waiting in ambush because I'd say that I'm sorry, but I'm really not. It's just too effective a tactic to not use it.
Roger. Got my eyes on.
So we are going to be using it. I hope Kyoken isn't gonna get shot at right now, because he should be theoretically safe. Come on over, baby. So it appears the mutants are chilling over there, holy crap.
Affirmative, covering now.
I'm on it.
Yeah, there is only one thing we can do, and that is overwatching. So let's hope that they will walk right into my ambush and die, preferably. I would like to kill something with those overwatches. Very nice. I'd say that this floater is a little less dangerous now, thanks to red fog. But it just ate all my overwatches, so anything that is following him is going to be fully dangerous. So he then... Okay, it's dashing. This one is on a half move. And it's shooting KO! Whoa! Fuck you, floaters. For some reason we can't really see those guys, which isn't cool.
Get out! Gonna have to reload soon.
There you go, we got one. It didn't die to a flash, but it died to a kill shot in the face. Okay, so now, again, Kyo's gonna get the hell out. Because his job is being a bait and nothing else, so there is really no point for him risking, and we still have overwatches to deal with the other floater. And then there is those guys. But I hope the floater isn't gonna live to see it, because we need all our ammunition to deal with the mutant threat. That's right, Garrett doesn't give a fuck.
Got him.
Come on! I won't go down without a fight!
No you won't, Van Dorn. No you won't. Now we gotta take care of the big bad Muton. Nice critical. Very good. I'm impressed and a little aroused. Now we can move on. There is more mutants where that came from, of course, because mutants never end. No. Fuck! No. Don't do that. Unfortunately, we do have to reload. And both of us have to reload, both the people who have vision on that guy, and Kingrike too. Well, I don't want to let that mutant just chill and do whatever it wants. So Kyoken is gonna have to start moving to advance. We have no more smoke grenades or anything that can protect us, and we have nowhere to retreat to reload.
Overwatch.
Meaning that the only thing I really can do is to... I'm going to try to break some of that, so that we may have a vision on it. I don't really count that much on that AG grenade to be so awesome. No, it wasn't. So yeah, the only thing we can hope for is that this mutant misses, because it can do whatever the hell it wants. It wanted to retreat, we scared it. Very good.
On overwatch.
Roger.
Overwatch.
Eyes peeled, Commander. Overwatch.
Come get some.
Overwatch.
So that's nice. We are going to wait on a full overwatch once more so that we see it, and if we don't, we are gonna start working on our reloads.
Good to go, sir.
On overwatch.
Ready to fire.
Because we are going to need the ammunition in a moment. Especially since we are about to start using Kyo as our bait once more. Looks like the mutant down there just saw me reloading and decided that this is not worth it, and that he didn't sign up for this. Which is what makes me a very happy panda. But, nonetheless, I would like that mutant to return, because I miss it. It was a good companion. Come on. It looks like Kingrike's gonna hit it.
Shot did not connect.
Yeah, that's pretty good. And now my tiny life is gonna miss once more. How can you miss a Muton? Well, I know it's moving, but it's the size of a barn, really. And Van Dorn knows it.
Come on! I won't go down without a fight!
Oh no, you do not. You don't. Okay, so it looks like this may be it. I'm going to just have one more round of Overwatches, just to be sure. I'm not sure how many of those were. There were 3 floaters and 2 mutants, I think, but I'm not sure. I can't really be sure. So, we are moving out. Again, I'm going to Overwatch for a while to see if there is more of them coming, because I think there might have been one more pod, so I'm going to give it like 5-6 turns of Overwatches to see if it comes. So, see you in a moment. Okay, so here I am once more. I don't think there is any more aliens, because nothing came. There was unfortunately one little problem. The baby woke up in the meantime, so... Right now she's going to record with me. I don't think she's gonna say anything because she just woke up, so we may have some time of peace and quiet still. What I'm going to do, we are going to move into phase 3, which is we are going to split into 2 fire teams once more, left and right. We are going to deal with the remaining 2 power conduits and then move to phase 3, which is the final destination. But of course it'll... is going to take a while.
Making the run for it.
I hope it's not going to take too long of a while, if you know what I mean.
I'm rolling.
Okay, so we are going to be sending 4 people in the right, 3 people in the left, and they are all together going to be my fire team. And I sincerely hope that there was not a mutant just chilling in there and waiting, because that would be annoying. So before we proceed, I'm going to first come around and get everybody in position, ready for the final breach of phase 2 and to greet phase 3 with open arms. Phase 3 isn't going to be taking all that much time. We are going to just place everybody in and around the engines. We are going to be prepared to deal with any terropins and... yes, that's gonna be it. I don't know if you heard the baby, but she said, because that's gonna be it. Okay, there are still enemies on board of the ship, not only the ones dropping in, there are also the ones coming, though. Look at that sectoid, look at it. Motherfucker. It's shooting me! Whoa, it missed. Yes you do, Garrett, yes you do. Come on, Garrett, shoot back. It's a miss, but that's okay. It was just a... It was just a diversion.
Orders confirmed. On the move. It's go time.
Okay, there is another pod. Not cool. Not cool at all. We are not prepared to deal with that.
Moving.
I mean, we are, but not really. Our chances are not that good. But hey, we gotta take care of that. We have to get rid of the floater that is closest to me. It's a miss! No!
Damn it!
No, 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 no.
Copy that.
I don't enjoy this at all. So at least get rid of the sectoid for me. Okay, that's the first time I see David Rice missed.
Missed the target.
It was going so well. What's happening? Why is this happening to us?
Adjusting aim.
I don't know either. I don't know either. So Peter Van Dorn is going to Overwatch in there just to make sure that the floaters don't engage us. Because that sucks. There is just nothing we can do to stop them. you're shitting me, game. How am I gonna do that? Okay, Van Dorn, take your 44. Ah.
No contact with the target.
Well then, make contact with the target, that's right. We gotta whisk that mutant out of there, there is just no way around that. Nobody's panicking, which is good. 62, 57, yeah, 62 is a good shot. There you go, King Reich made it. Actually, you know what I can do and forgot? I can holo-target that muton. Did you know? that when it snows, my eyes become larger. Anyway, we are gonna kill that bitch. And that means we are now theoretically ready to take care of everything else. Come on, David. Alright, that's a hit, not a kill, it's okay.
They're trying to pull back.
It's a... Yeah. They're trying to pull back. We can't let them pull back. Because that would be silly.
Roger that. Scanning.
And that means we are gonna have to keep ourselves on Overwatch, because...
Eyes peeled, Commander.
I don't know if you remember, but there is a little sectoid just waiting on the rooftop that we didn't get to yet. And of course there are those guys. Floater is going to flank Keo. Kill it! Kill that bitch now!
Basket, Mr. Basket.
No! It's flanked, so I hope it's not gonna shoot. It's gonna go away. It's gonna go away. It's going away! Fuck yeah! Good, good. That was probably the single most dangerous floater in this mission. Luckily it chickened out, because floaters are cowards. And now... we can get something done theoretically, it all depends on where is the last remaining sectoid. I don't know either, baby. I don't know either.
Overwatch confirmed.
Come get some.
Move it to Overwatch.
Staying frosty.
Yeah, we have to overdose because there is sectoid somewhere.
Overwatch, aye aye.
And I don't mean this guy, I mean this guy. Please die. Oh yeah, now we're safe. And now we can advance when I have all the fire teams in position to deal with the enemy coming in to destroy me. Then we can... then we can proceed. So how do we proceed? Of course we are going to proceed by setting up by the engines. We are going to turn them off at the same time while setting everybody on Overwatch, so that no matter what drops down, it's gonna go straight to hell. Baby, well, is that a good plan, baby? Yeah, do you like the plan? So now she got shy. She always does that. Now she just wants to take my mic. No, you baby working for Exalt. No, I won't go down without a fight. I won't go down without a fight.
What's making that noise?
No. Up, up, up. Oh no! Oh, it's got me! Okay, yeah, I'm sorry for that sudden noise. That was baby sitting on my lap, and she is actually fast enough to grab that mic before I even have time to react. I have a ninja baby. Oh no 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 no, go away. Shoo. That's not how
Decision
you chase
confirmed.
Off a baby. Okay, we got one. It's 40%. It's better than nothing. I know Van Dorn can do it. And he did. Booyah.
Come on! I won't go down without a fight.
That's right, you tell him. And that means we can now safely move on. We have eliminated all remaining hostiles for now. Except for the hostile baby that really wants my microphone. No. No. I see that I see the devilish smile in your eyes. You don't do it.
Hitting there now.
I won't let you do it.
I'm on it, sir.
Rack tap bang.
Okay.
The power conduit is disabled, but you've got three more to go.
I'm going to have David fix my tiny life, because I completely forgot that she's being hurt. Okay. We need people on their best.
There's another conduit down. You only need to deactivate two more.
We need everyone at their best. So we are going to set up lots of overwatches. I hope that the enemies drop down somewhere where I can see them, but that's not a given.
You've got a wave of X-rays closing on your location. Eyes up.
I like this, come on. Did you see that? Okay, Tiny managed to destroy that Tin Man. And that's it. Okay, so that went well. We have one splosh of acid and another splosh of acid is also ready. So what's going to happen now? We are going to converge over here before we move on. We are going to get everybody
on the move.
In the best positions available. We are going to now move in a tourelier formation rather than splitting into two fire teams. Actually... No, we are going to remain in two fire teams. I am a little undecided, but that's because... well, you know... I had a better idea whilst talking. It's not a better baby, so... it's probably not a... A what? What were you saying? Huh? Okay.
Aye, aye.
Yeah, well, it's gonna be safe, don't worry. You know it's gonna be safe, right? She's nodding her head, so... I didn't even know she spoke English. But she does, apparently, so there we go. Hello. I don't think that team is fully aware of the situation. And this guy is a problem. And this guy is a problem. Okay, so apparently this is what's happening. We are being mobbed. Can I push a grenade up there? I don't think so. Okay, I can? No, I don't think so. Baby says I can, but I think she's lying. Alright, so we can at least... Oh, come on, Van Dorn, you have to hit it.
No contact with the target.
Oh yes, that's what I talk about. That's what I'm talking about. We managed to ice them just in time. And what's gonna happen next? The only thing I can do is to overwatch against the incoming Tin Mint. It's gonna get shot at a lot. But I hope, all I can do is hope that it's gonna be enough. Fuck! Yeah. Oh crap, I just scared it in front of a baby. I'm sorry, baby doesn't speak English, so... she's not gonna remember it anyway if I don't make a big deal about it. So yeah. Phew! Yeah!
That
we might...
looks like a small fusion reactor. If we could recover it, it may prove extremely useful to our weapons and propulsion research efforts.
I'm sorry, Dr. Shen, but we are going to sell that thing. We need it. Okay, so now David Rice is going to close down one of the gates. I mean, conduits. And the Maverick's going to close the other, and that is going to be the end of it.
Overwatching.
Just in case something drops down, we are completely prepared to protect them.
I'm watching.
Affirmative. Covering now.
And that is it.
Conduit Boom. Down. Only one more to go. Take that out and the ship is ours.
Boom! 41
Nicely
areas
done, Commander.
Later.
That ship is now officially under XCOM control. Although I don't think it will fit in the hangar.
Da-da-da-da. Can't touch this. Okay, so we managed to get through this 41 aliens down. We are coming home, everybody's in one piece, and we are rocking the swagger like real pirates. We are going to scrap that booty and sell it. Let's see what do we have that's sellable. I would like to sell something else that's not a fusion power. That's not the fusion reactor, because I really like
that
them.
Are sure to boost everyone's confidence. Well done, Commander.
That's what you see. You see it correctly. There is not a wounded person. Nobody is wounded. And Maverick Allen will want to see the build that he left me, if he have left me a build. My card is safe for now, but now that the baby has saw it, then we are doomed. Okay, Maverick Allen did not left me a build, but we are going with this one, so I'm gonna go with Executioner, or maybe Ranger. Ranger or Executioner. I don't know. I think Ranger is gonna be working better with double tap, but then again, Executioner gives me additional crit chance.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with Executioner. It's gonna be good. I'd rather have more aim than more damage. Yes, that's right. And what do we get? We get, of course, tons of corpses, two cyber dicks, and 103 Ellerium, 104 alloys, 10 meld, weapon fragments, flight computer, power sources, fusion cores, everything goes. Okay, I'm going to have a lot of stuff to fix, which I will not have the money to fix unless I will sell the power sources. That's going to put me back above ground, and that way I don't have to sell the fusion cells. 22 goes for the healing. We have started another month, and we have one satellite in orbit, zero available, which is a problem. However, I'm gonna show you in the engineering, we are going to have one satellite in 5 days, two satellites in 11 days, and another one in 2 days. So that's gonna be good. We are only waiting for satellite uplink in 12 days, and we are taking over North America, and thus making our life much easier when it comes to money. It's going to make my Monty funding in the plus again, hopefully. Hi. That's right. And we are now working on a team and autopsy so that we can get the advanced medkits. And the covert operation is in 2 days.
Contact detected.
We have a scout coming in. I'm gonna send a Rushmore to take it down. He only has one kill. Baby's nodding her head that it was a good decision. Rushmore can take care of it, right? Of course, yes.
Engaging bogey.
Do you have
approaching target now?
Come on, come on. Come on, don't fuck. Don't fancy that, getting interceptor damage like this, but at least we have shot down that UFO. And that means our next mission is going to be a training mission. Since we have shot down a small UFO, I can get my specialists up and running, and that's gonna be good, right? So, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If so, let me know in the comments, like the video and so on and so forth. Follow me on Twitter, Facebook and so on and so forth. You know, the whole shebang. So, bye-bye!